Welcome back, guys. In this episode, we are going to do the gigantic, enormous freight yard. And I'm going to throw up a picture here. Right, this is my inspiration for this. And I'm going to try and do something that's kind of, sort of similar. So you can tell, this is huge. I mean, seriously, freaking enormously huge. And so we need a big area to do it in. And I've been kind of looking around the tracks, and there kind of aren't too many, like, big spaces. Especially like a big flat space that we could use. I mean, the biggest flattest space is probably kind of over here, but we got the airport there, so I can't do that, and I'm not moving that blooming airport now. So the only other place that I could find was kind of over here, this area here. So this is the area that we're going to use, but even this, I mean, it's not flat. And I'm gonna have to flatten this area. This area is gonna have to be like pretty much dead flat. So there's gonna be a huge amount of work. So you know what? I'm gonna dive straight in and get on with it. What I'm gonna do, because I can't move this, obviously, this is an immutable object. Well, unless I get the mod that allows me to delete industries. But I kind of don't want to do that. I want to work with what I've got. I'm gonna flatten the terrain to this level, and I think that's actually probably about right. But it's, man, the amount of terrain that I'm going to have to like flatten is mammoth, and then putting this in, it's going to be crazy. So you know what? I think we cue the time lapse and I start getting on with it.
the song. It's extremely dangerous.
Man, okay, well, we've got the basic layout for the yard that I want. Now it's a case of kind of like laying in some tracks and trying to get the shapes and stuff right. So we're going to be coming in off the Mega Halo at this end and then into probably this yard first. Let's do this yard first. So let me lay. Now, I think... In fact, I'm almost 100% sure I'm going to do this without catenaries because they just make it too busy and too fussy. So I think I'm going to be using lines without catenaries. And I'm really tempted to use standard tracks rather than using the high-speed tracks just because they look a bit grubbier. So if I lay a track down the middle there, like that kind of thing. Alrighty. See, it's just a bit grubbier, which I think is nice for a freight yard. So, let's see. Okay, so... Let's get at least a basic layout for this. So, what do I want? Let's mark this. So, I want something kind of about there. So, let's get rid of that. And... Now, I'm going to have to kind of play around with, like, what kind of spacing I want for the tracks and, like, exactly how big I want these and all that kind of stuff. So there's going to be some playing around with this, which is going to be so freaking awesome. And let's take these out. Now, I think what I'm going to end up doing is maybe having these like spaced out like every other one. Kind of like that is what I'm thinking. But we'll kind of see what it looks like. Let's do a little section. So, yeah, what do I want? I want tracks again. But you can see this is huge. There's going to be a hell of a lot of track here. And you. We're only about halfway out to there. We've got a long way to go. I told you this is huge. Yeah, absolutely huge. But we'll see. It may evolve. Who knows? I may even scale it back a bit. I may decide, it's a bit too big. I'll scale it back, but I don't know. I kind of like the idea of having something this huge. And there are other options for things that we could play around with. So let's see. Actually, I'm just going to bring it down to there. So hopefully I can just delete them in one section. So can I delete them in one section? Yeah. It's not. No, can't delete them in one section. Oh, God, now it's playing. Doing loads of little sections. That's annoying. Wow, that really slows things down. Okay. All right, so let's run you down there. Man, I think there's going to be more time lapse going on when I start laying out all of these because it's going to take a while. But I want you to kind of at least see the initial stages because, like, I don't know how this is going to look. Okay, so take you out to there. So I'm looking at this already and thinking this might be a. Might be a fraction too big, but we'll see. You kind of never really know until you actually get finished. Oh God, I hate the fact that it goes into these tiny little sections. It's kind of frustrating because it just takes so damn long to demolish like one little section of track. especially when it's being laggy like it is at the moment. I probably need to restart the game. There is a memory leak in the game, which slows things down. It seems like if you leave it running for too long, and it gets a bit upset. Let me extend these first before I do that. So what I want, tracks and. There we go. I should have done these shorter. I really should have done these shorter. Like, why am I extending these? I'm an idiot. I'm making work for myself, but you learn as you go along, I suppose. If I can get this to look anything like this, this could be epic, guys. It could be epic. Alright. Boom, boom. Right, one more. Oh, come on. Stop going into such little sections. Oh my god, it's getting worse. It's getting freaking worse. Look. Look at like 6 million sections. Right, so. I'm starting to like the look of that. Right, get rid of you. Right, and then run you. Yeah, don't want this to curve, so. I think that's pretty straight. Yeah, I think spacing the tracks out the way that I have is probably the way to go. Now, the kind of the tricky bits are going to be like how we connect them together, and this is going to be part of like how things are spaced out and stuff. So let's see. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Well, that's kind of good because that gives me 3 4s, doesn't it? Now, so if we have a track, I don't know, kind of. Actually, the way to do it is to extend one of these like that, and then put a piece in there. Now that means that's dead in the middle of these two. Oh, good idea. Right then. That's maybe a bit far out. I want to bring that in. Because I want these end bits to be fairly tight, I think. How close can I get this and make this work? So, too much curvature. Take it back a bit. Ugh, too much curvature? Really? That's... Oh, come on. Come on, work. Okay, so if we add something like that. And that. This going on to there. Oh, man. Yeah, this. Trying to get them to hook up. Not so easy. Ah, now, see, if you come out that way, it's actually easier. Okay. But too much curvature. Man. Okay, well, see, this is the learning process. So, take that back. Try and do it a little section because I want to try and find out what's the minimum distance. Okay, that's... Yeah, I can't do it like that. Put a little section there so I know where I'm kind of going up to. And so you, we want up to there. And then we want you to come off there and hook up to that. Oh man, too much curvature. Man, that's kind of brutal. Well, we'll push it back a bit further then. Jeez. Okay, so let's take it back to, I don't know, like there. And that section off. Well, keep your fingers crossed. Oh, good lord. Okay, that must be straight because it's 75 miles an hour, so it must be straight. And, okay, so try again. Run you down to there. You up to there, and then can I get you to come off and go into there. Oh, come on. Oh, man, that's not so good. That is not so good. Seriously, these ends are pretty tricky to get hooked together. Man. Which I guess is because of the spacing, but if I don't space them out like that, then it's going to be like seriously difficult to kind of space the place out and make the place look big and impressive. So, okay, well, let's see. Well, like, how far out do you actually have to freaking go? So, no, and take that out a bit more. We'll put another bit in there. More and more difficult. Where's 75? There's 75, right. Okay, so. Down to there, and hook you back up. Can you see, like, how, like, I'm doing one tiny little bit, one tiny little corner of 1 yard, and I want, like, 4 massive yards in here, and plus all the bits in between. It's huge. It's massive. But if I can figure this out, then it might be easier. So, I'm going from there, aren't I? Hang on, yeah, I'm going from there, aren't I? What the hell am I doing? Let's try that again. Okay, get rid of all of that, right. So that goes into there. That one goes all the way up to there. And then, oh my God, hooray, success. And then, can I get the other one to go in? That's the thing. Yeah, I can. I think that's about as close as I'm going to get them, so. Now, the thing is, having done that, see, what you want is for these lines to come all to come together. So, let's see. Man. Now, what's the tightest that could come around is something like that. Because ultimately they've got to come together up here. Okay, so let's run this track out a little bit. To about say there. Okay, now if we were to bring that like round there like that. Now the question is, can we then get this all to like hook up together? So we'd want to do the same kind of thing. So we want to run, let's say that. Oh, yes, space. Little bit of an issue. Good lord. That's as far as I can go. Okay, so let's go out to there. So, and I want to be in between the two of them. So there. Man, that's going to be tight, isn't it? That's like seriously going to be tight. So you come into there. I don't know if we're going to have enough room, but we'll try. Can I do it from that end? Ah, I can. Ha. Okay. Okay, that's as far up as I can go. That's the same distance as that one. So like that and like that. Aha! So and then it can hook onto that one. And then we do the same, hopefully with this one, but this one's going to be slightly different. So you're going to go into there. We want them fairly straightish, don't we? But the problem is if I have too much track on there, it's not going to work for that one. So I think that one's going to have to... Yeah, I don't know. Do I bring them together like I did the other one? I don't know. As this is the outside one, maybe we do something slightly different. So we bring you up to there. Bring you... Ah! Stop sticking together. God damn you. There we go. So bring you up to there. That's just about straight, I think. So you like into there, and you into let's bring that up a little bit further. Alrighty, and we start to create some kind of interesting patterns. What do you think? What do you think, guys? I'm kind of liking that. I'm kind of liking that rather a lot. So we'd have like 12 on that side and then 12 on that side linking into this kind of pattern. Alright, cool. And then we're going to have a line that's coming off over like from here across here and then feeding into this one as well. This is going to be another one like this, but it's going to be longer. Then we're going to have some messing about in the middle and then there's going to be another long one down here and another short one there. And then we start throwing buildings and stuff like that in. So, right, having figured out like kind of at least roughly how we're going to do this. And the thing is, I'm looking at this and thinking, that layout works if I was doing another two tracks on this side. But if I want two sets of four, if I was adding two sets of four onto here, then it would look the same. But if we're going to have three sets, so another 12 tracks on this side, then actually we want this lining up to a central point there, which gives us some issues. I'm gonna have to have a little think about this, I think. Okay, so after a little bit of messing around, I've come up with a design that I'm basically happy with. So what we're gonna have is the two sections are gonna have two tracks joined together like this in the middle. Like that, and then we're going to have this kind of design bringing the tracks together, which I'm hoping should look fairly impressive when I've done it. The thing is, I'm looking at this and thinking, I'm wondering what's going to stand out more. I may end up switching to high speed tracks because the high speed tracks just stand out a little bit more. But the problem is I can't tell at the moment because I'm probably going to change the terrain. There's a mod which I haven't actually picked up yet, but I'm going to pick it up, which allows you to paint the terrain. And you can either paint it with this kind of stuff in between the tracks, which I think is probably what we'll be using for most of it. But there's also like concrete and grass and other stuff. So yeah, we can play around with the terrains and make it kind of look good. Maybe some concrete areas would make this kind of stand out more. I don't know. We'll see. So yeah, right. So what I need to do now is kind of lay this out. So well, I have the right tracks. That's a good plan. Is lay this out. That's. Well, that one can come all the way down, can't it? Yeah. So that one can come all the way down to there. Collision. What the hell's that? Oh, it's colliding with that. Yeah, so I need to get rid of that station. If I'm going to get rid of that state. Well, no, I don't need to measure that, do I? No, because I know how many tracks I'm going to have coming out on this side. So that's fine. Right, so if we bring this, just bring this one down a bit like that. So let's see, how many tracks am I going to need? So 1, 2, 3. I shouldn't have taken the middle bits out, should I? Idiot. So I want a bit down like that, and like that. All right, so that's 1, 2, that's 3. That's 4. That's 5. No, I've already lost count. You know what? Let's just throw a bunch in, I think. If I do that and then bring you down a bit. No, I can make some more. And then I don't have to delete so much. Yeah, that works. I think that works. So don't worry, what I'm gonna be working on now is just like the general layout of the tracks around the place, and then we'll go to time lapse to actually like finish it off. So let's see. So this is one, this is two, three, four, five, that's six to there. Seven, eight, nine. So that's 10. That's 11, and I can't quite get the next one in. Oh, come out straight. Thank you. What did I say? That was 6. 7, 8, 9, 10. That's 11. And that's the last one. Hooray. So then all I'd have to do is repeat that pattern over here. But the thing is, like, once you've got one side in, because you know where your markers are, it kind of makes it a lot easier. So that's going to go into there, and that gives us the same shape roughly as that, but not quite, because to get this one to work, I had to actually bring that one up a little bit. So see, what I actually need to do is kind of figure out. So yeah, I brought it up like that, so I just need to extend that one a little bit. It was just, oh, come, give me a, right, that I think is about right. And I need to actually bring it out from the top. I'm learning so much about track laying doing this. And yeah, I think that's more like that curve. But I'll find out when I try and hook the tracks up and stuff. So now I know that this track that goes out here starts up here. So you can see when I actually do this. So two, three, that one comes out to there, doesn't it? No, it doesn't, because it's not doing the same thing. Hang on. Oh, man. Oh. Okay, what the hell's different? The hell's different? One, two, three, four. That's a one, two, three, four. That's the right one. Why isn't it doing the same thing? Oh, good lord. I've got to figure this out, because like that's kinda sort of weird. Hang on, is that one coming down to that? Did I do it like that? Oh, I did it like that, didn't I? Yeah, that's how I did it. So that one comes down to there. And then I got my marker for that one comes. Oh dear, there you go. So God, how easily I confuse myself. And then I know where that marker is to come out for. Whoops. If I actually come out straight to that one. Oh my God, they're all going in. They're all going in. And then where's the last one? Oh, that's the last one, isn't it? Yeah, one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Hooray! My God. And then get rid of these. I'm doing now what I said I wouldn't do, but you got to admit, it's so much freaking fun. Okay. So now I can take the outside track down here. So that's to about there. And I could do the same thing if I want, coming out this end to get these absolutely level, which would be a good idea. So that's gonna be kind of cool. So this is gonna come, like, we're gonna do the same similar thing at this end that I've done at that end. Now let's take the tracks off the Mega Halo. Now, they're obviously going to have to come through. Now, we're gonna have kind of a main set of tracks running through the centre here, with a bunch of buildings around and stuff like that. So I have to start sorting the terrain out a little bit. Sorry, but little bit more messing around with the terrain. Hopefully not too much. And this just needs to be kind of blended into the surroundings, so it's not too extreme. A bit more down here, I think. Like that kind of sort of thing. I'm not going to worry about that bit. Okay, so how are we doing? All right, cool. So we want to take some tracks off here. So now the question is, am I going to use the standard tracks or the high-speed tracks? I don't know. So, now, signals. I've turned signals off. I need to see where signals are. Okay, we need to come off before those signals. So I'm thinking we want to be coming... where's the next set of signals? Ways away. So, I don't know, maybe something like... something like that. So, we bring you down onto here. Like that. Cool. So, that's my marker there. So, you are going to come off like that. Let's bring them all off the tracks. I think it's going to be easier. You go up to there. Oh, seriously, how much fun is this? Oh, I'm so glad I decided to do this. After all the hassles that I've had with the airports, it's nice to do something that's just fun. And I don't have to make it work, because it's all just for looks. But, oh, I think it's going to look good. If I dress it up with some nice buildings, I think it could look freaking awesome. Gotta do a good job on this. Right, so we bring that up like that to there. Now, we're going to have all kinds of crossovers and stuff going on, but I'm thinking, like, maybe we just, like, run these two tracks into there, like that. Oh, come on. Like that. And, like I said, we're going to want all kinds of crossovers and things, so, like... yeah, we'll cross those over like this. Ooh, just goes in. And we'll do another one on the other side. So you're going to... we'll make this one a little bit longer maybe. So that one comes out to there. Ooh, won't quite go in. Let's try. Ooh, why won't you do that? I have such problems putting these X's in. Let's start you from there. Let's come out a little bit further. Let's try there. See if that will go in. If it doesn't go in this time, I'm going to skip it and I'll do it later offline. There we go. Boom. Okay, so those lines can get across. So we've got to do all kinds of crisscrossing between these tracks so that different trains can get onto different lines and all that kind of thing. So I think then maybe we bring this up like this kind of direction. You want to be a little bit straighter than that, or see, I'm thinking we're going to have from here, we're going to have the tracks coming around here to probably to these two outer tracks. They're all going to crisscross, or I'm going to try and get them all to crisscross. So like, I'm going to put links in from here to here and all this kind of stuff. But if we had that kind of like, that kind of thing. Now, this is about this line. So this is going to come out to about here. Kinda. So if I just put a little bit of track in there as kind of a marker, and then, so we're going to have this track coming around, I don't know, probably something like this. And then coming around here. Ooh, now, if I hook it up to there, will it just do something nice? Yeah, it will. Yeah, although we want the terrain up a bit, it's come down too sharply there. Yeah, it's a bit too sharp. So let's... If I, you know what, if I take that back to there, I wonder, will you put in, like... Oh, it won't quite. Bring it out a tiny bit. Bring it out to there. Come on, put it in. Put it in, go in for me. Oh, you son of a... Okay, a little bit more to there. Now you're going, you son of a... Yeah, that'll go in. That one won't, though. So, you know what? I don't think I'd get another one inside. So if I put that to there, and then run this one around like this, up to... Oh, come on. What the hell's wrong with you? Just join up with you. There we go. And run it up here. Now, what I'm going to do is, because that's not particularly nice there, so, well, yeah. Take that bit out. Okay, that doesn't like that. Okay, fine. God, so fussy these tracks. Run you up to the end. Right, then hook you up to there. There we go. And then that comes around to there. Sweet! Okay, so that's gonna split off into that one. These ones coming up here. Now, how steep is that? That's all right. Can live with that. These are gonna form the kind of the through tracks that are going to go through here. So I think probably what we want to do is just run a track from, say, about there to, I don't know, what do you think? Kind of there-ish? Yeah, that'll do. And then put that onto there. Cool. Do the double track and run you down here. Alrighty. Okay, so we've got that yard there. We're gonna have this slightly longer yard there. But I'm just looking. See, I'm just looking at this end piece and how big that kind of end piece is, and thinking. This is maybe going to have to either get moved down a bit further or be kind of foreshortened. And I think this is going to need to be extended a little bit. Well, I don't know, though, you know, because it's going to be curving round, isn't it? But yeah, we're going to need more space in between the two to get that kind of end piece on there. We'll make it work. So these two lines are going to come through here. And then you know, the sensible way to do it, Sky, would be to put a piece of track in there like that and then hook it up like that. Cha-ching. Yeah, you are going to come all the way up to there. Cool. So, now we want a similar kind of thing down here. Right, now we've got these two depots. Obviously, since we're doing all this nonsense, we can get rid of these. So, bye-bye. You. Right, now I've got to get rid of this stupid bit of track in here. That. Try and do it without deleting any other tracks. Right, oh, and you. Any other bits? No, we're good. Right, so, where are my tracks? My tracks are coming down here. These were the middle tracks. So yeah, we'll be joining. So we've got, that end piece is gonna kind of join onto here and that's gonna come a bit further. So yeah, I might have to make that a bit shorter. I don't know, we'll see. It's not over yet. There's some tricky stuff to come. Okay, I've got this to deal with, haven't I? Yep. Okay, so where are we going to join onto here? Do I kind of curve that round, then this can join onto it, and then we'll join on after these signals down here? Yeah, I think that's a reasonable plan. So if we start somewhere like there. Yeah, what are you upset about? Okay, so you'll come off like that, but not like that. Let's try starting a little bit further down, like that. Well, that's the best you're going to do. Okay, well, if that's the best you'll do, then that's the best that you'll do. So, where are we? Where's our little... Yeah, there's our little switch. So, you can come up to... Oh, seriously? The hell's wrong with you? Okay, let's extend that out a little bit. Just straight like that, and then see if we can get this to hook up. That's my marker. Oh, come on. Like, seriously, why the hell would that have a problem? And of course there's a freaking train in the way now. just to make these a little bit more difficult. Alright, you, and we'll do this again. Ah, it's gonna be tricky, but if we can get this bit done, then the basic layout is all there, and then I can just like lay all the tracks in a nice time lapse. And I'm kind of rocking from there. Let's try from there. Let's come out a bit, I don't know. Let's try that. See if we can get the next one to hook up. What did I do over here? Because this worked like really easy. Yeah, okay, well. Maybe it just needed to be a slightly more acute angle. I guess we'll find out, won't we? So that's my marker there. Come on, please. Oh, there we go. There we go. So, you come up to there. Oh, yeah. I can't wait to see your comments, guys, because I think this is exactly the kind of thing that you want me doing. Really silly things. And you come up to there. And the last one. Oh god, I lost my markers. Here we go. The last one comes up to there. Alrighty. So now, all we got to do is hook these middle two tracks up to wherever. Where the hell was I putting the tracks? Ah, around there. Now, will you just do it? I think I'm doing that one, aren't I? Nope, doing the other one. Oh, that's just clipping that, you see. Okay, so we'll need to extend these out a little bit more. That. That. Take that one. Come on now, hook up. Hook up. Hooray! Oh, that's perfect. That's peachy. Alright, so you come around and you're going to hook up to this one. Alright. That's nice. That's really nice. Okay, so yeah, I can do a similar thing on there and hooking it into this and hooking it into this. So now at this point, do I want to mess around with putting buildings in and stuff? Yeah, it's a really good question because we've got some really nice buildings that we can start putting in here. You know what? Let's come over here to where it's flat. What I'm going to do is kind of lay out the buildings that I've got to play around with. So we've got the DB Lagerhalle, which is that one, which is a trackside building, which is kind of nice. That's a Schenkerhalle. Yeah, that could probably get used somewhere. The net house. The net house is a signal house, I'm pretty sure. And then we got that one and the... Now, that one is supposed to be like a big train shed, I think, as far as I know. And then, got that, not going to use that. This is one of my favourites, which I've used quite a bit already. So we've got that one. And then I've got my now, I don't think there's anything in there. Oh, does that? Yeah, I don't think we'll be using that one. Yeah, I don't know, maybe. Let's plop you there. Now, where are my depots? Ah, depots, they're in depots, Sky, you idiot. So these are the other ones that we've got to play around with. So we've got our regular depot, obviously. And then we've got, now that's just the plain bit of track, which I don't know, we may use around the place, but we'll see. I'm probably going to end up using fake trains, but that's another mod that I've got to pick up and play around with. So then we've got this. This one's freaking awesome. I love that. That really is awesome. And that's going to fit in really nice with these big trains. We'll have like some of these along the outside and in the middle and all kinds of stuff. Oh, we're going to have an epic time, guys. And then, what do I want then? I want... then we got the fat one. That's where the fat controller lives, I think, in that one. And then... that was tenuous, wasn't it? And then we got this white one. So, we've got a whole selection of buildings that we can use in here. So, like this one, I mean, we could do things like, for example, and this is probably a good idea to have a little bit of a play around and get an idea for the kind of way I want this to be. So, oops, a little bit of lag. So I'm thinking, you know, you could have, like, I don't know, you could have maybe something like that. And then if you flip it around, yeah, rail. Flip it around. Now, bear in mind, these stations are all going to go and be replaced with just track. So we're not going to have these buildings. But you start throwing some of these in. These would need to be, I think, maybe spaced out a little bit more. But... yep. Just try to go from that side. So, nope. Yeah, I think they need to be spaced out a little bit more. Ooh, that'll go into there. That one wonder if we can get the other one in. Well, how far out was I? About there. Too much curvature. Let's come back a touch then. So about there. Oh my god. It'll actually do it. Unbelievable. And then you can, have so much fun. Like, really, I should have brought it into the outside and then put one. You know what? Let's do it. Let's do it. What the hell? Why wouldn't we? So, yeah. Oh, come on. Oh God, how do I? Oh, is it there? Yeah, it's there. So if we bring that one out onto this, I need to do it from the other side, don't I? So I need to do it from. Let's see. So, yeah, I don't know about there. So if we. We bring you and hook you on like that. Alright, and then take this one maybe there. Bring it onto there like that. We can get all kinds of nice complicated lines running around the place. Should I do the other one? Seeing as I've done one, should I do the other one? Yeah, God, let's do the other one. Why the hell not? The thing is, I know that this is probably going to change later. Because I'll look at these buildings and think, yeah, these need to be lined up better or something. I just know that stuff's going to change. So, you. How far up did I bring it? About there. Oh, my lord, the fun we can have with this. See, I'm now. Okay, perfect example. I'm now looking at this and thinking, if I had like two of these on this side in between this yard and the main line going through here, and then put two on the other side and then link them up the way that I've done like this. Oh, that could look really good. So yeah, there's gonna be all kinds of playing around. And where we've got kind of gaps and stuff, we can throw in buildings and things. So I don't know, and this is gonna take some play. I mean, you've kind of got to throw stuff in and kind of just see what it looks like, and then you kind of build up a feel over time for like how you want it to be. So I don't know, I mean, you could have something like this over here and then hook this up into there like that. Cha-ching. Obviously, a bit of terrain smoothing required. Just tart this up and see what it kind of looks like. Do 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 do. Fill in that hole there. Yeah, do 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 do. Smooth this track out. And along here as well. Do 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 do. Oh, I love it. Come on, level out. And you, terrain, all nicely level. I just want to kind of give you an idea at this point what it's kind of going to look like when it's finished. Well, finished-ish. All right, how's that? Yeah, here we go. Oh, yeah, mama. But you get like one building on its own, yeah, kind of boring. So what do? Yeah, well, you get another one, and you spin it around 180 degrees, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, like that, and then stick it on the other end. Yeah, maybe angle it slightly like that, plunk it in there. Yeah, do I want a two-tiered effect? We want a second shrubbery. Let's do it the other way. So let's do it from there. There we go. And the nice thing is, you can do things like okay. Yeah. Oh, I can't quite get it to go where I want it to be. Oh, that's a shame. I was just going to get it to terminate kind of like there, but it's kind of difficult to get it to do it. Come on, change colour. What about... Oh, Oh, I can get it to do it from there. Now, you know what? We need a little bit of track to start it, don't we? And then bring it onto this track like this. Like that. And okay, it's not going into the building, but it kind of looks the part. All right. So I'm sorry, but the OCD is insisting that I do a little bit of smoothing there. And smooth that out there. There we go. Yeah, I'm already looking at this and thinking, yeah, that actually needs to come up. That needs to be lifted up a little bit. It doesn't look that great, does it? Yeah, let's make that a little bit bigger. I mean, like, could I live with it? Yeah, I live with it, but I like the two tier, but I think it just needs to be a little bit higher than that. Maybe bring it up to kind of this line here. So it's just, it's down a bit, but not quite as much. That's a bit too steep. Yeah, I like it. This is gonna be great.